Good morning students, now we will discuss two questions of exercise 6.5. See here, angle Q and angle R of a triangle PQR are 25 degree and 65 degree. Which of the following is true? Means in this question, triangle PQR is given to us. In this triangle PQR, angle Q is equal to 25 degree and angle R is equal to 65 degree is given to us. And this first, second and third, three equations are given to us. Which equation is true, that we have to identify. So see here measurement of angle Q is given, measurement of angle R is given, angle P measurement is not given. So first we will identify angle P. This we can identify according to angle sum property. What is angle sum property? The sum of measures of all the angles of triangle is always 180 degree. Means angle P plus angle Q plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. So see here, angle P plus angle Q plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. Now angle P we have to identify. So angle P plus then plus angle Q. Angle Q is equal to 25 degree plus angle R. Angle R is equal to 65 degree. Is equal to, then is equal to 180 degree, then 180 degree. Now angle P plus 25 plus 65, then it is 90 degree. Is equal to 180 degree. We have to identify angle P. So 90 degree side we have to change. So it is on other side of the equal, its sign is negative. So angle P is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree. So angle P is equal to 180 minus 90, then 90 degree. Means angle P is equal to 90 degree. This angle P measurement is equal to 90 degree. If angle P is equal to 90 degree, then triangle PQR is the right angle triangle. So according to the Pythagoras property. What is Pythagoras property? The square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of square of legs. See here, in this triangle PQR, QR is the hypotenuse and PQ and PR both are the legs. QR is the hypotenuse, PQ and RP both are the legs. So according to Pythagoras property, square of hypotenuse means QR square. QR is the hypotenuse. QR square is equal to sum of square of the legs. Which are the legs? PQ and RP both are the legs. Means PQ square plus RP square. Sorry. PQ square plus RP square. See here. Square of hypotenuse is equal to PQ square plus RP square. Now we will interchange. PQ square plus RP square this side and QR square on other side. So see here. PQ square plus RP square is equal to QR square. See here, PQ square plus RP square is equal to QR square. Means second equation is right. So this statement, PQ square plus RP square is equal to QR square, this statement is right according to the Pythagoras property. Now see here, next question. See here, find the perimeter of rectangle whose length is 40 cm. And diagonal is 41 cm. Means here one rectangle is given to us. The rectangle's length is 40 cm and its length of the diagonal is 41 cm given to us. We have to identify perimeter of the rectangle. First we will consider rectangle is PQRS. See, consider rectangle PQRS. See, this is the rectangle PQRS. This is the rectangle PQRS with length is equal to SR is equal to 40 cm. Because length is 40 cm. So SR is equal to 40 cm and it is the length of the rectangle. And see this SQ. SQ is the diagonal and its length is 41 cm. See, consider rectangle PQRS with L length is equal to SR is equal to 40 cm. And diagonal is equal to SQ is equal to 41 cm. This is the diagonal SQ. Now see here, rectangles all angle are right. We know that rectangles all angle are right. So angle R is equal to 90 degree. See here, angle R is equal to 90 degree. This angle P is equal to also 90 degree. Whole angle S is also 90 degree. Whole angle Q is also 90 degree. So rectangles, all angles are right. So angle R is equal to 90 degree. Now see here, in triangle SQR, this is the triangle SQR. This triangle only we have to consider. In triangle SQR, angle R is equal to 90 degree. And SQ is the hypotenuse. Why SQ is the hypotenuse? Because it is the opposite side of the right angle. In triangle SQR, angle R is equal to 90 degree and SQ is the hypotenuse. RQ and RS both are the legs. So according to Pythagoras property, what is Pythagoras property? The square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of square of the legs. So what is hypotenuse here? SQ and its square. So see here, according to Pythagoras property, SQ square is equal to, SQ square is equal to sum of the square of its legs. Which are the legs? QR and SR. So SR square plus QR square. What is QR? See, QR is the breadth of the rectangle. QR is the breadth of the rectangle. So according to Pythagoras property, SQ square is equal to SR square plus RQ square. Now what is SQ? See, SQ is equal to 41. So 41 square is equal to SR is equal to what? 40. 40 square plus QR square. Plus QR square. Now we will interchange 40 square plus QR square. We can write on LHS side, and 41 square we can write on RHS side. So this we can write this side, and 41 we can write on other side. So see here, 40 square plus QR square is equal to 41 square. 40 square plus QR square, this side, and 41 square on other side. Now see here, 40 square means 40 we have to multiply 2 times. So 40 multiply 40, then it is 1600. Plus then plus QR square means QR square is equal to square of the 41. Means 41 we have to multiply 2 times. So square of 41 is equal to 1681. 1681. Now we have to identify QR square. So 1600 side we have to change. So 1600, this side it is positive, it become negative on other side of the equal. So QR square is equal to 1681 minus 1600. So QR square is equal to 1681 minus 1600, then it is 81. Now we have to identify QR, and here QR square given. So we have to write square root sign on both sides. So see here, QR square is equal to square root of 81. QR square root is what? QR. And square root of 81, 81 square root is what? 9, 9 ja 81. So is equal to 9. So QR is equal to 9. And QR is what? Breadth of the rectangle. So QR is equal to 9. So B is equal to also 9. B is equal to also 9 centimeter. Now we have length of the rectangle 40 centimeter and breadth of the rectangle 9 centimeter. And we have to identify perimeter of the rectangle. We know the formula to identify perimeter of the rectangle. See, perimeter of the rectangle is equal to 2 multiply L plus B. 2 multiply L plus B. So perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 multiply, L means length of the rectangle. Length of the rectangle is 40. So 40 plus then plus, and breadth of the rectangle is 9. So perimeter of the rectangle is equal to 2 multiply 40 plus 9, then it is 49. So perimeter of rectangle 49 multiply 2, so it is 98 centimeter. So perimeter of the rectangle is equal to 98 centimeter. So this is the normal explanation of two examples of exercise 6.5. I hope you can understand this. Thank you.